Any brothers who may want to get the Quran, then they may do so, and inshallah they can follow us as well. So if there is anyone in the gathering or those who are listening at home and they want to follow us whilst the Quranic verses are being read, so they can also take the Quran and inshallah we'll go through it. So it at least brings some familiarity with words as well. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فإنما يسرناه بلسانك لتبشر به المتقين وتنذر به قوما لدا Sadaqallahu al-Aliyyul Azeem. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters listening at home, I greet you with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is a perfect opportunity for us to listen to the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try and understand the kalam and the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a letter to us. It's a conversation and it's a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He wants us, yatlu alayhim ayati, to recite the verses. Wa yuzakkihim, and to purify our souls through the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa yuallimuhumul kitaba, and to learn the book and create an understanding in the book and then to propagate and teach it to others. And wal hikmah, and wisdom through the ways of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this verse has been recited and repeated four times in the Quran, that the prophetic mission was yatlu alayhim ayati, to recite the verses of Allah. It is unfortunate that we've restricted the mission of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam simply to the recitation. Certainly recitation of the Quran is important and it is rewarding. However, this was only one goal of the mission of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ, to purify the soul with the verses of the Quran. How can we purify our souls? How can we adorn our souls? How can we instill and inculcate the love of Allah, the love of His words in our hearts, if we do not know the word of Allah? وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابِ, a mission and the purpose of revelation is recite the revelation, cure your hearts through the means of revelation, understand, create an understanding. We have created an understanding of everything, of all other sciences and subjects. But if there is no understanding, then it's of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, cure your hearts, cure yourselves from illnesses through the Quran. Why? It's shifa, it's a cure. Take the pill. Bring it into your lives, apply it to your lives, and it will bring happiness in your lives. It will bring tranquility in your lives. It will give you a sense of direction. So the purpose of us assembling here is to, fortunately, with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, create an understanding, an attachment, a connection to Allah's and Allah's words. So in these few moments we have, I would like to summarize the Surah Maryam. We hear many discourses, many lectures. These lectures on Fridays, these occasional lectures at the weekend, are simply motivational, inspirational, a wake-up call. But they are not opportunities for us to learn, educate, receive ilm. Allah says, قُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. O Prophet say, Rabbi, my Lord, zidni, increase me, ilma, in knowledge. Now to acquire knowledge and spiritual knowledge, we will have to create a deep understanding in the Quran, in the ways of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, we will concentrate particularly on the verses here and their translation and very brief commentary. Obviously, in the few moments that we have, we will unable to cover the whole surah. in its commentary, with its detailed explanation, as it's required. However, we can at least for a moment hear the words of Allah. Secondly, hear the translation of those verses. Thirdly, a brief explanation. And hopefully, that will inspire us to leave from this gathering and to tell ourselves, I need to open the book of Allah and try and understand. I need to attend the Arabic courses. I need to attend the local provisions. I need to enroll at a local program. I need to understand the Quran under the supervision of reliable scholars. And this is unfortunately what we are lacking. We are content with our Friday prayers. We are content with our five daily prayers. We are content with the outer appearance. But Allah will strengthen our faith by us strengthening in our education and knowledge. So it's very important and vital we try and understand. And hopefully the idea is we hear the verses and we'll be able to recall the translation later. Hence what we said was that if some people wished to have the Quran and to continue with us, then hopefully each time you read these verses, it will ring bells, it will help you to recall and remember some of the messages Allah is sharing with us. Most certainly you won't become a master in Arabic, you won't become a translator, you won't be able to provide a commentary, but at least it will provide some importance and provide some significance, and it will help you recall some of the messages. So without taking further time, today's discourse will particularly focus on Surah Maryam. Surah Maryam is Makkiyah. There are two types of surahs, chapters. Some are Makkiyah, some are Madaniyah. Makkiyah are those surahs which were revealed before the migration to Medina. Makkiyah. Madaniyah are all those surahs which were revealed after Hijrah to Medina of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Here now we have two types of surah, Makkiyah and Madaniyah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was blessed with prophethood at the age of 40, and he propagated and he called people to Islam. The Muslims faced many challenges. They were persecuted, they were boycotted, they were driven out of their homes, they were chained, they had split from their families. So the verses focused on belief, iman, yaqeen, tawheed, certainty, belief in Allah, in prophets, in the book of Allah, in akhirat, in resurrection, in fate, to console the believers when they were persecuted and to strengthen them in faith. Once they were strong in faith, Allah allowed them to migrate first to Habasha, Abyssinia, almost 5 years after being blessed with prophethood. Then eventually, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam allowed the Sahaba, the companions, to migrate to Medina. Here now, they were not persecuted as they were in Makkah. They had the freedom to practice their faith, and they were strong in their faith. So then Allah revealed the verses of jaiz, najaiz, halal, haram. What must a person do? What must he not do? So this surah, Surah Maryam, is Makkiyah. Since it's Makkiyah, as we can imagine, the verses will focus on iman, on yaqeen, on tawheed, on the stories of the prophets. Why stories of the prophets? لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ, to strengthen your heart. You're going through persecution. You're going through sufferings, trial and tribulations because of your faith. But there were those who came before you, they were also trialed. They were also persecuted, but they were steadfast in their worship to Allah, in their covenant to Allah, and Allah made them successful. Likewise, challenges will come your way, but remain steadfast. Do not compromise with your faith. Why? Because the victory and the nusrat and the help of Allah will be with those who stay steadfast. So this surah consoles the believers. It's Makkiyah. And it appears in the 16th juz of the Quran. The name of the surah is Surah Maryam. Because there's a 16th verse, it says, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ. Remember in the kitab, in the book, in the scripture, Maryam. And there's a whole account from 16th verse all the way to 34th verse about the account of Maryam radiallahu anha. And therefore this surah is known as Surah to Maryam, because it recalls and recollects Maryam radiallahu anha's brief life. Now Maryam radiallahu anha is blessed. She is the only woman to be mentioned by name in the Holy Quran. There are almost 25 prophets mentioned in the Quran by name. There is only one companion, Sahabi Zayd radiallahu anhu, mentioned by name, a companion. And there is only one woman mentioned by name, that is Maryam radiallahu anha. One of the explanations is that she's a woman of great merit and virtues. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, from amongst the menfolk, many reach excellence, but from amongst the women, there were only few, and from amongst them was Maryam. Secondly, it was the custom in Arabia that a person shies away and embarrasses from naming his wife. Therefore, the women in the earlier times were known as Ummu Fulan, the mother of so-and-so, or Bintu Fulan, the daughter of so-and-so, or Imra'atu Fulan, the wife of so-and-so. And here, Allah forbid, there were those who said Maryam. Maryam was the wife of Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions Maryam by name to dispute them, to deny their allegation upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has a wife. Now, this surah also entails a sajda. There are 14 sajdas in the Quran according to the Hanafi fiqh, and here the fifth sajda appears. In terms of revelation, this surah was 44th. 44th surah to be revealed. However, in terms as it appears in the Quran before us, it's the 19th surah. As we know, the Quran does not exist in the form before us as it was revealed. Because the first verse was Iqra' bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq, which appears in the 30th juz. So Surah Maryam has 98 verses and 6 rukus, and it was revealed in the early period of Mecca, almost 5 years after prophethood, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was 45 years. The Muslims, as we said, were persecuted. They were driven out of their homes. And when the difficulties became unbearable, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam allowed them to travel to Habasha, Abyssinia. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, there is a king who is a Christian, who is just by nature, who is gentle by nature. Go, you will be able to practice your faith freely without being persecuted. So many Muslims migrated from Mecca all the way to Abyssinia. And there were only about 40 Muslims who remained in Mecca. And now the people of Mecca, the non-believers of Mecca, could not tolerate this. So they sent their messengers and envoys with gifts. And they came to the king of Habasha and they said, these people have left our homes. They have left their localities. They have split their families. They have created terror in the homes. They have created disorder and confusion amongst the masses. Drive them away from your land. Return them to Mecca. Otherwise, they will also create disorder in your land as they did so in our land. So try to instill terror and fear in the hearts and the king of the people of Habasha. The king of Habasha, Najashi, was an intelligent and clever person. He summoned the group of Muslims. Ja'far, the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, spoke. And briefly he explained that we were people in ignorance, and Allah took us out from ignorance and darkness and guided us to the right path. We killed innocent people. We violated the rights of the widows and the orphans and the travelers. And the Prophet came and he brought to us the teachings of the oneness of Allah, taught us good things, to be dutiful to others, to fulfill the rights of others. So the king of Abyssinia was impressed by the words of Ja'far, was impressed by the teachings of Islam, and allowed them to live amongst them. Now, the people of Mecca who had come to persuade and convince the king to return these people to their land came once again. And they said, don't you want to hear about their beliefs in regards to Isa, whom you believe in? When they were called once again, An-Najashi, the king, wanted to hear some of the verses of the Muslims in regards to Isa alayhi salam. And Ja'far radiallahu anhu recited these verses of Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ain, Sad. And when he was reciting these verses, Umm Salama radiallahu anha says that Fabaka wallah An-Najashi hatta akhdala lihyatahu. He heard the verses of Allah and he cried and he wept until he caused his whole beard to go wet. Not only this, كانت أساقفته حتى أخذلوا مصاحفهم. The bishops and the religious men heard these verses of the Quran and it touched their hearts so much so that they also started to weep, and the scriptures and the holy books which were in their hands also became drenched in their tears. حين سمعوا ما تلي عليهم, when they heard the verses of Allah, Najashi said, verily the verses that you read and the verses we have heard from Musa and Isa alayhi salam are from the same lamp or from the same lantern. Here you have the freedom to practice your faith freely in Habasha. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, he refutes the concept of Isa alayhi salam as held by Christians. The Muslims were migrating. Yahya alayhi salam, he was persecuted. Isa alayhi salam was persecuted. Therefore, in Surah Maryam, Allah discusses Ibrahim alayhi salam. He was persecuted. He had to leave his home. He had to leave his family. He had to leave his locality. But because they were steadfast, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assisted them, and their legacy still lives with us. Likewise, O believers, you will have to stay firm. You may need to leave your homes. You may need to migrate to Habasha. You may miss the alleys of Makkah. You may miss your homes. You will be separated from your families. But wastabir li'ibadati, as long as you stay steadfast in the worship of Allah. If you stay faithful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will assist you. Allah will look after you in this world and the hereafter also. So Surah Maryam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discusses tawheed, the oneness of Allah, and calls the people to believe in Allah and the beliefs in the prophethood. Now before this Surah Maryam is Surah Kahf, Alhamdulillah, which we should be reciting every Friday. And here in this surah, there are amazing incidents. The people of the cave, the incident of Musa alayhi salam, of Dhul Qarnain. Likewise, here are miraculous, amazing stories of Yahya alayhi salam and Isa alayhi salam. So it's a continuation of amazing stories. Secondly, in both it shows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy, rahmah, descends upon those who wish for it. Firstly, we see that the people of cave were in difficulty. They prayed to Allah, Rabbana atina min ladunka rahmah. Oh Allah, give us your rahmah. Allah says, verily your Lord is ghafoor and dhu rahmah. Then in the story of Musa alayhi salam, Khadr says, Allah has blessed me with rahmah. In the end of the story, he says, rahmatam mir rabbik, it is the mercy of your Lord, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhul Qarnain, he erects a wall for the people to stay away from the fitna of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. And he says, Hada rahma, this is mercy of my Lord. Likewise, these verses begin with, Dhikru rahmati rabbik, it is your mercy of your Lord. We cannot do, I cannot do, you cannot do. We can only do that which is out of the rahma and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you're migrating to Habasha, but stay steadfast and keep hope in the rahmah of Allah. Just as He protected those before you, He shall also protect you. So we may also have difficulties in our lives. We may also have challenges. We may also have hardships. But we must migrate, move away from sins, move away from places of sin, and keep hope in Allah. Keep hope in the rahmah and the mercy of Allah. Times will be difficult. You will be tested by the means of your wealth. You will be tested by the means of your professions. You will be tested by the means of your family. Be steadfast. But remember, Ala inna awliya Allah. Become on Allah's side. And la khawfun alayhim wa la hum yahzanun. You will have no fear. You will have no grief at all. So Allah starts with kaf ha ya ain sad. This is amazing also. This is a code which Allahu a'lam bi muradihi. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what it means. ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recalls the moment when Zakariya alayhi salam entered the mihrab, the private prayer of place of Maryam radiallahu anha. A mihrab. Mihrab literally means the place of war. Harb in Arabic means war. So mihrab means a place of war. Now why is mihrab known as a place of war when obviously it's attributed to prayer according to us? Because when a person is in his mihrab, in his place of prayer, he is at war against the shaitan. He's at war against the dunya. He's at war against anything which moves him away from the seclusion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he finds Maryam that she has beautiful fruits out of season, which Allah discusses in the third juz. And he asks, where did you receive this fruit from? And she says, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is at this moment Zakariya alayhi salam nada rabbah nida'an khafiya, calls Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nida'an khafiya in a secret prayer. And he says, oh Allah, wahana al'azmu minni, my bones have grown feeble, washta'ala ar-ra'su shayba, my hair have turned gray and white, but walam akun bidu'aika rabbi shaqiya, but I am unblessed, hopefully I am unblessed in my invocation, in my supplication to you. Oh Allah, there is no one after me who will protect the deen, who will be my inheritor, who will assume the responsibility of propagating the religion. I have no children, but I have faith in you. Give me children. It is amazing. Here Zakariya alayhi salam is more than 100 years old. He's almost 120 years old. His wife is 90 plus. But he asks from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَهَبْ لِي مِن لَّدُنْكَ وَلِيًّا, give me an inheritor from you who will inherit. وَجْعَلْهُ رَبِّ رَضِيًّا, give me children, and give me children who you are pleased with. رَضِيَ, jin se aap razi ho. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا زَكَرِيَّا إِنَّا نُبَشِّنُكَ بِغُلَامٍ. O Zakariya, we give you glad tidings of a child. إِسْمُهُ يَحْيَا, his name will be Yahya. لَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلُ سَمِيًّا, we have not given this name Yahya to anyone before him. So Allah gave Zakariya alayhi salam the glad tidings that soon they will have a child, and Allah named the child Yahya. Now he was shocked. And he said, أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامٌ, how can I have a child? وَكَانَتِ امْرَأَتِي عَاقِرًا, and my wife is aqira. Aqira means barren. وَقَدْ بَلَغْتُ مِنَ الْكِبَرِ عِتِيَّا, I've reached an extreme old age. Allah said, كذلك, so it will be. قال ربك هو علي هين, it is easy. وقد خلقتك من قبل ولم تك شيئا. Why? I created you when you were not into existence. Now how difficult is it upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to create a child? Be your age 120, be her age over 90, but if by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with faith in Allah, the impossible can also become possible. He asks Allah, اجعلي آية, make an ayah for me. Ayah means a sign. قال آيتك ألا تكلم الناس ثلاث ليال سوية, your sign is that you will not be able to speak to the people ثلاث ليال, for 3 nights سوية, though having no bodily defect at all. So فخرج على قومه من المحراب, he left his place of prayer and he came to his people. He was not able to speak. This was a sign that his wife will soon give delivery to a child. فأوحى إليهم, he made a gesture to them, سبحوا بكرة وعشية, glorify Allah in the morning and the evening. Allah says, يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبيا وحنانا من لدنا وزكاة وكان تقيا. that, O Yahya, take the book with quwwah, with strength. And we gave him hukm, wisdom, ability to judge while yet a child. So Allah gave all the prophets the natural ability and wisdom from a very young age. وَحَنَانًا مِنْ لَدُنَّا And we made him sympathetic to others. So from amongst the traits of the prophets are that they are sympathetic, caring and gentle to others. وَزَكَاهُ And we made him pure from sins. Zakah. Zakah means purification. And because by giving 2.5% from our wealth annually, we are purifying the rest of our wealth. So zakah literally means purification. So he was pure and clean from any type of sin. وَكَانَ تَقِيَّ تَقِيَّ تَقْوَى He was God-fearing. وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَيْ And he was dutiful to his parents. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ جَبَّارًا عَصِيَّ He was not arrogant and he was not عَصِيَّ عَصِيَّ means disobedient. Allah says, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيْهِ Peace be upon him, يَوْمَ وُلِدْ The day when he was born. وَيَوْمَ يَمُوتْ The day when he died. وَيَوْمَ يُبْعَثُ حَيَّ And when he was resurrected alive. Continuing from here, now I'll recite the Quranic verses and let's hear the translation because we've heard the surah and we've heard the account of Maryam and the birth of Isa alayhi salam many times. Let's hear from the verses of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرُ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ And remember in the kitab, in the scripture, the account of Maryam. What happened to Maryam? إِذْ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا إِذْ انْتَبَذَتْ When she withdrew in seclusion مِنْ أَهْلِهَا From her family مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا At a place facing east from Masjid al-Aqsa. So she went to the east. فَاتَّخَذَتْ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ حِجَابًا And she placed a screen from them so no one could see her. Hijaba means screen. Hence many people assume hijab means a scarf. No, hijab means a screen. It means seclusion. It means to ensure a dress code by which a woman hides and conceals each and every part of her body. So فَاتَّخَذَتْ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ حِجَابًا فَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا رُوحَنَا Allah says, أَرْسَلْنَا We sent إِلَيْهَا to Maryam رُوحَنَا our spirit. Ruh is Jibreel. فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا He came to her in a form of a bashar. Bashar in Arabic means a human. So he came in a form of a human in all respects. She was not able to distinguish whether he's a human or whether he's an angel. So when he approached her, obviously it was a modest woman. قَالَتْ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ مِنْكَ إِن كُنْتَ تَقِيًّا Here, inni a'udhu bir-Rahman. She said, I seek refuge in ar-Rahman, in the most merciful. Minka from you in kunta taqiyya. If you are taqiyya, taqiyya taqwa. If you are God-fearing, stay away from me. Bir-Rahman. There is another note I will explain about ar-Rahman. The word ar-Rahman has been used multiple times in this surah. The people of Makkah knew Allah, but they did not know who ar-Rahman was. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thereafter says in the 15th juz of the Quran, call him Allah or Ar-Rahman, it is one deity. The most merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will shower his blessings upon you. Bir-Rahmani minka in kunta taqiyya. So the angel, قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَسُولُ رَبِّكَ He said, I am a Rasul. I am a messenger of your Lord. I have come with a message. What message? لِأَهَبَ لَكِ غُلَامًا زَكِيًّا To announce to you a gift of a غُلَامًا زَكِيًّا A righteous child. This was the conversation between Maryam and this angel who appeared in the form of a person. So she's confused. قَالَتْ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامٍ How can I have a child? Why? لَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرْ No bashar, no human has even touched me. وَلَمْ أَكُ بَغِيًّا I am not an immoral, illicit woman. I am not married. No man has ever touched me. I have done nothing wrong. How can I fall pregnant? So the angel said, so. It is as Allah has wished. It is easy. Why? Because Allah created Adam without a mother or a father. Hawa. How difficult it is upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to create this child, at least from a mother. Huwa alayya hayyin. It is easy. وَلِنَجْعَلَهُ آيَةً لِلنَّاسِ وَرَحْمَةً مِنَّا. We hope to make him an ayah. As we said, ayah means a sign. A sign of the miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a mercy from us. وَكَانَ أَمْرًا مَقْضِيًّا. And this is a matter which is already decreed. We cannot run away from the fate, from the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was the conversation, the angel disappeared. Then Allah says, فَحَمَلَتْهُ فَانْتَبَذَتْ بِهِ مَكَانًا قَصِيًّا. She conceived the child. Jibreel blew in the sleeve of Maryam radiallahu anha and is settled in her womb, and immediately she fell pregnant. Now she's worried. She's confused. What will she say to the people? She's frightened. What will I say? What will I do? And sometimes we are confused in different matters. Whether it be at workplace. If I perform my ablution and perform my salah amongst the people, what will the people say? If I stay steadfast on my deen and it's the occasion of the marriage of my children, if I don't follow the custom and the culture of my people, though it may be against Sharia, what will be my name? There will be shame. There's worry, there's concern. And therefore, فَانْتَبَذَتْ بِهِ مَكَانًا قَصِيًا. She goes to a far place. She doesn't want to be noticed. Allah says, فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَىٰ جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ. And the pains of childbirth drove her إِلَىٰ جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ, to a trunk of a date palm tree. نَخْلَة is a date palm tree. قَالَتْ. Allah recalls and she says, يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًا. Would that I had died before this. Why do I have to see this day? What will I say to the people? كَا چَهْرَا بَتَاؤُنْغِي. What will I say? وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًا. Only if I had been forgotten. Only if I was out of the sight of the people. فَنَادَاهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا. And there was a call from beneath her. Some commentators say that it was the angel. Some say it was the actual child, Isa alayhi salam. Allah tahzani, don't grieve. The Quran has been revealed with sorrow. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam says. So recite the Quran with sorrow and sadness. Read the Quranic verses. Try and understand them. Have emotions. Why? Because when you have emotions, you will find messages and direction from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here also Allah tells us, لا تحزني, do not fear. If you have Allah with you, do you need to fear anyone? Allah تحزني. And miraculously, قد جعل ربك تحتك سريا. It was a barren land. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed a تحتك سريا. تحتك means beneath you, سريا, a water stream. So she could actually drink from the water stream. And then Allah said to her, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ. Shake the date palm tree. Why? تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُتَبًا جَنِيًا. It was dried. There were no dates. But by the will of Allah, Allah will allow the branches of the date palm tree to let fall fresh ripe dates. Allah says, فَكُلِي وَشَرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا. Eat from the fresh dates. وَشْرَبِي. Drink from the river. قَرِّي عَيْنَا. Be glad. Do not worry. Have faith in Allah. فَإِمَّا تَرَيِنَّ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ أَحَدًا. If you see any bashar, if you see any human, فَقُولِي. Simply say, إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَانِ صَوْمًا. I vowed to keep a fast. فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا. I will not speak to any insiya, insan, any human today. Obviously, in our universal, in our Sharia, there is no fuss of talking. There is a fuss of disallowing ourselves from consuming food or drink. But there is no fuss from speaking. But in the previous Shari'ats, there were also fuss of speaking. So Allah told her to go, return to the people and not to utter any words, but to gesture that she is unallowed to speak because she's fasting. So have faith in Allah. Allah will open your avenues for you. فَأَتَتْ بِهِ قَوْمَهَا تَحْمِلُهُ. So she came to the people carrying the child. When the people saw Maryam, and Maryam was known, Maryam was a righteous woman, they said, لَقَدْ جِئْتِ شَيْئًا فَرِيًّا. You've done a mighty thing. يَا أُخْتَ هَارُونَ, O sister of Harun. مَا كَانَ أَبُوكِ امْرَأَسَوْ وَمَا كَانَتْ أُمُّكِ بَغِيًّا. Your father was not a bad man. Your mother was not an illicit woman. How did you do this? Spirituality, it continues in generation. Your parents were pious. We expected and we entertained good hope in you that you'll also be pious. How do you have a child? Out of wedlock. فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ. أَشَارَتْ إِشَارَتْنَا. So she pointed to the child. And obviously people were confused. قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيًّا. How can we speak to a child who is in the mahd, who is in the cradle? Immediately, Allah gave power of speech to Isa alayhi salam. Although he was in the cradle, he was only a few days old. He said, إِنِّي عَبَدُ اللَّهِ آتَانِيَ الْكِتَابَ وَجَعَلَنِي نَبِيًّا وَجَعَلَنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنتُ وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيًّا وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَتِي وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدتُّ وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيًّا. All these words were of Isa alayhi salam. And it's most amazing. Qala, he said, Inni Abdullah. Abdullah, I'm the servant of Allah. So the first thing taught by Isa alayhi salam whilst in the cradle was not that he was God, not that he was the son of God, he was the humble servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, if we want to reach out to Allah, express humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdullah, be humble in your speech, be humble in your walk, be humble before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, Allah has given me kitab, book, injil. He has made me a nabi, a prophet. وَجَعَلَنِي mubarak. He has made me mubarak. Mubarak means barakat wala, blessed. Aina ma kunt, wherever I may be. Wa awsani bis salah, Allah has instructed me to observe salah. Wa zakah, charity. Ma dumtu hayya, as long as I'm living. Wa barram bi walidati, Allah has told me to be dutiful to my walidati, to my mother, because he did not have a father. Wa lam yaj'alni jabbaran shaqiyya, Allah has not made me arrogant and unblessed. And peace be on me, the day wulidtu, I was born, the day I shall die, the day when I will be resurrected alive. This is the account of the birth of Isa alayhi salam. Allah says, Dhalika Isa ibn Maryam. This is Isa, the son of Maryam. Qawl al-haqq alladhi fi yamtarun. This is haqq. This is the word of truth in which the people dispute. Why ma kana lillahi an yattakhidha min walad? How can Allah have a child? Subhana, he's pure. Subhanallah. When we say Subhanallah, Subhan means Allahi that pake. Allah is pure from any shortcoming or any weakness. إِذَا قَضَىٰ أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. When Allah decides a matter, he says kun, be, and it becomes. In fact, Allah is not even in need of the word kun. Then amazingly, Allah says, oh, Isa alayhi salam said, وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ فَعَبُدُوهُ. Verily, Allah is my Lord. وَرَبُّكُمْ, and Allah is your Lord. فَعْبُدُوا, only worship Allah. هَذَا صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمٌ. يَهَ سِيدَ رَاسْتَ. This is the right path. Sirat means path, mustaqim means right. Allah says, فَاخْتَلَفَ الْأَحْزَابُ مِنْ بَيْنِهِمْ. Ahzab, the sex differed, the groups differed in regards to Isa alayhi salam. فَوَيْل, destruction be to لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, to the disbelievers. مِنْ مَشْهَدِ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ, from the meeting of a great day. Why? أسمعي بهم وأبصر يوم يأتوننا لكن الظالمون اليوم في ضلال مبين. They are unable to see it today. They are unable to hear. سُمٌ بُكْمٌ عُمْيٌ. The disbelievers, the Quraysh of Mecca, are deaf, dumb and blind. They are not understanding. But how clear will they be able to see on the day of judgment? How clear they will be able to hear on the day of judgment. يَوْمَ يَأْتُونَنَا, just in the day when they will come to us. And on that day, الظَّالِمُونَ, the oppressors, it will be known that they are in dalalim mubeen, in clear error. Now there is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the people of Jannah will enter into Jannah, when the people of Jahannam will enter into Jahannam, then maut, death will be brought in the form of a mixed colored ram. And it will be placed between Jannat and Jahannam. It will be said to the people of Jannah, هَلْ تَعْرِفُونَ هَذَا? Do you recognize this? They will look, they will stretch their necks, and they will be informed by Allah that this ram represents death. And then the angels will summon the people of Jahannam, هَلْ تَعْرِفُونَ هَذَا? Do you recognize the ram? And they will reply, yes. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command for this ram to be slaughtered. Death will be slaughtered. And the angels will say, Khulud la mauta fi, Khulud la mauta fi. For you will be in Jannah for eternity. La mauta fi, there is no death in it. O people of Jahannam, Khulud, forever and entirety you will be in Jahannam. La mauta fi, there is no death. Forever and ever and ever you will stay in. Then Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam recited these verses. وَأَنذِرُهُمْ يَوْمَ الْحَسْرَةِ إِذْ قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ وَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. O Prophet, أَنذِرُهُمْ, unko darao, warn them of the day of hasra. Hasrat, which we say in Urdu, anxiety and worry and grief. Why? Because the disbelievers will want to return to the world. There are many similar verses in the 28th juz of the Quran in Surah Al-Munafiqun. Allah says that the disbelievers will be resurrected and they will cry and plead to Allah that return us to the world and we will give charity. مِن قَبْلِ أَن يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولُ, and he will say, Rabb, O my Lord, return for us sadaqah. I will give charity. I will look after the widows, the orphans, the travelers, those who are in need. وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ, I will be from the righteous. I will do good things. فَلْنَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلْ. We will do good actions, not those, the evil actions which we used to do. But it will be said to them that there is no death anymore. So this is the day of hasrat, grief and sorrow. إِذْ قُضِيَ الْأَمْرَ, when the amr, when the matter, when the case will be finished and concluded. Allah says, وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ, today they are in the state of carelessness. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, they do not bring faith. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَرِثُ الْأَرْضَ وَمَنْ عَلَيْهَا وَإِلَيْنَا يُرْجَعُونَ, we will inherit all the wealth and everything they have, and to us they will return. Then briefly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discusses different prophets. He says, وَذْكُرُ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ, and mentioned in the book Ibrahim. Ibrahim was a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said to his father, Ya Abati. Now this is amazing. Abi means my father, Ya Abati. Each time a prophet addresses his father, whether he's a believer or not, they say, Ya Abati. The ta gives the meaning of pyar, muhabba, love. Oh my beloved father. Although their father may have not been a believer, they always address their fathers with respect and honor. Not by their name, not simply by daddy or father, my beloved father. لِمَ تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ وَلَا يُبْصِرُ وَلَا يُغْنِي عَنْكَ شَيْئًا. Why do you worship the idols which can't hear, which can't see, and cannot avail you in anything or benefit anything? Verily knowledge has come to you, that which has not come to you. أَهْدِكَ صِرَاطًا سَوِيًّا, listen to me, I will guide you to the right path. Do not worship shaitan. Because shaitan wants you to associate and ascribe partners to Allah. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لِلرَّحْمَنِ عَشِيًّا. Oh my father, إِنِّي أَخَافُ أَن يَمَسَّكَ عَذَابٌ مِّنَ الرَّحْمَنِ. I fear if you do not turn away from your old ways, then an azab, a punishment for ar-Rahman will come to you. As here you can see there's a continuous wording of ar-Rahman, ar-Rahman, ar-Rahman. Because Ibrahim alayhi salam is reminding his father, you may have lived a life of 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 years of disobedience, but turn to Allah once. He is the Rahman. He is the most merciful. He will forgive you and all your ways. So Allah tells us that also turn to Allah. I am the Ar-Rahman. Call unto me with the words of Ar-Rahman. قَالَ أَرَاغِبٌ أَنْتَ عَنْ آلِهَتِي. Do you reject my ways, our culture, our values, our way of life, O Ibrahim? If you do not abstain from this, then لأرجمنك وهجرني مليا, I will stone you, leave me to my ways. Here when Ibrahim a.s. was convinced his father will not listen to him, he said, Salamun alayk, peace be on you. سَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكَ رَبِّي, I will seek for forgiveness from my Lord. إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِحَفِيَّ, he's gracious. And the most important thing he did was, وَأَعْتَزِلُكُمْ مَمَا تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَدْعُوا رَبِّي, he turned away from his father, he turned away from the locality of sin and focused to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, when he moved away from the locality of sin, the people were driven away from Makkah. We may be driven away from the places of ma'asiyah, but turn to Allah. He turned to Allah. Allah says, وَهَبَنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبُ, we gave him the glad tidings of Ishaq and Ya'qub. Why? Turn away from sin, and Allah will give you glad tidings and make you steadfast. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recalls the account of Musa alayhi salam, and he says Musa alayhi salam was mukhlas, chosen. He was a Rasul and a Nabi. We called him وَقَرَّبْنَاهُ نَجِيَّا, we drew him closer and spoke to him in seclusion, Najiyya. Because Musa alayhi salam was known as Kalimullah, one who versed with Allah. Then Allah said, we strengthen him with our mercy, with his brother Harun. And Musa and Harun were told to go to Fir'aun and give da'wah. Yet they were told that when you give da'wah, be humble, be gentle in your words. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Isa, Ismail alayhi salam, that he was truthful in his speech. He was a Rasul and a Nabi. He commanded his family members of Salah and Zakah, and he was Mardiyya. He was beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah speaks about Idris alayhi salam. He was Siddiq and Nabiya. He was truthful prophet. Allah says, and we raised him, we protected him from his enemies in a high place. Now before we conclude, Allah here discusses many prophets. Yahya alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, Idris alayhi salam, and the mutual relationship between them. Then Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ آدَمَ وَمِمَّنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَ نُوحٍ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْرَائِيلَ وَمِمَّنْ هَدَيْنَا وَاجْتَبَيْنَا إِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُ الرَّحْمَنِ خَرُّوا سُجَّدًا وَبُكِيًّا. We ask for guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our prayer. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Who are those who are rightly guided? Allah says, Ulaik. They are those whom Allah blessed. The messengers, Nabiyeen. From the progeny of Adam, those who are embarked on the ship with Nuh alayhi salam. From the progeny of Ibrahim and Yaqub alayhi salam, whom we rightly guided. Wajtabayna, and we selected. And when the verses of Ar-Rahman are recited unto them, kharru sujjada wa bukiya, they fall sujjada, sijda karte hue, in prostration and bukiya, in weeping. This is the ayah of sajda also, and we must also make a sajda after. This is one of the 14 sajdas of the Quran. So when the verses of Ar-Rahman are recited, then the servants of Allah fall into prostration and they cry. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says, when you recite a verse of the sajda, then don't hasten in your sajda, cry a little. If you can't cry, then at least make an expression of a person who's weeping. Try and understand the verse of Allah and cry and shed tears, because Jahannam and the hellfire will not touch a person, will not touch a person and his a'adha and the body parts on which he sheds a tear out of the remembrance and the khashya and the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence we said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Quran was revealed with sorrow and grief. So read the Quran with sadness whilst contemplating on the verses. And if you can't cry, then at least make an expression of a person who's crying. From here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, فَخَلَفَ مِن بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُ الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهَوَاتِ. Then after the prophets came the people, jinone zaikardi adha'u, those who neglected their salah, wattaba'u shahawat, followed their desires. If a person follows his desires, he feels himself disattached to goodness and he feels himself more inclined towards bad. Wattaba'u shahawat. Fasawfa yalqawna ghayya, soon they shall receive ghayya. What does the word ghayya mean? Ghayya either means destruction. A Mufti Taqi Sahib, he translates ghayya as the outcome of their evil ways. Or ghayya is the river in hellfire, which is out of the pus of the inhabitants of Jahannam. So those who neglect their salah, those who are careless in their salah, those who live their lives according to their own desires, they shall receive ghayya, the river of the pus of the inhabitants of Jahannam. Allah says, "Illa man taba wa amana wa amila saliha." But those who do taba, repent to Allah, amana, iman li aye, bring faith in Allah, wa amila saliha, do righteous actions, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ, they will enter into Jannah. وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا, Allah will not be unjust to them. جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ الَّتِي وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَانُ عِبَادَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ, the Edens and the gardens of paradise which Allah has guaranteed His servants, بِالْغَيْبِ, in the unseen. In many verses Allah says, لَا يَبَغُونَ عَنْهَا حِوَلًا, when you enter into Jannah, you will never feel like moving away. In this world, we may visit amazing places, but after a few moments, we become tired. You could go to the most beautiful, amazing scenes and have the most beautiful and pleasant holiday. After a few days, you want to return home. But you will never want to return away. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا وَمَا هُمْ مِنْهَا بِمُخْرَجِينَ. Unfortunately, we all had holidays, but there's always something at the back of the head. We need to return to our workplaces. We need to return to schools, colleges, university. So even the most amazing experience is spoiled by that thought. But the most amazing ni'mat in the hereafter is that you'll be surrounded with blessings and with the amazing feeling that these will remain with you forever and ever and ever. Allah says, "Ata'an ghayra majdood." This will be a ata'. Ya Allah ki taraf se hiba hoga. It will be a gift of Allah. Ghayra majdood. Never be will cut off from you. Inna hada la rizquna ma lahu min nafad. It will never come to an end. Ukuluha da'im wa dhilluha. You will eat from the branches and from the fruits of Jannah forever and ever and ever. And the shades will surround you forever and ever. Allah says, when you enter into Jannah, لَا يَسْمَعُونَ فِيهَا لَغْوَى, you will never hear anything idle, futile, but salam, peace. Soon as you enter the khazana, the people and the angels entering, and those who are opening the gateway will grant you the salam. مَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ. You are patient in the world. Enter into Jannah with peace. لَهُمْ رِزْقُهُمْ فِيهَا بُكْرَةً وَعَشِيَا. There will be provisions, بُكْرَةً وَعَشِيَا, evening and daily morning. تِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي نُورِثُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا مَنْ كَانَتْ سَقِيَّا. This is Jannah. For whom? For everyone? No. مَنْ كَانَتْ سَقِيَّا, جِسْمِ التَّقْوَاهِ, whoever is God-fearing. The next few verses is, Jibreel alayhi salam was asked by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا يَمْنَعُكَ أَن تَزُورَنَا أَكْثَرَ مِمَّا تَزُورَنَا. What prevents you from visiting me more than you actually do? Some scholars explain that the people of Mecca challenge Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to ask to what ruh, spirit was, the account of the people of Kahf, cave, and thirdly, about Dhul Qarnayn. What are these three? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was expecting revelation, but Jibreel did not come. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was confused. And he asked Jibreel, why did you not come to me later on when he did? Before, when the people of Makkah was expecting their response. Then Jibreel replied, وَمَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ. We angels don't descend but when Allah commands us. لَهُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِينَا وَمَا خَلْفَنَا وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ. That which is ahead, that which is behind, that which is the past, that which is the future, everything between the two only belongs to Allah. But remember, you may forget. وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ نَسِيًّا. Your Lord will never be forgetful. رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا. The Lord of the heavens and the earth. وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا. That which is between them. فَعَبُدْهُ. Only worship Allah. فَعَبُدْهُ. إِسْكِ عِبَادَتْ كِيجِي. وَاسْتَبِرْ لِعِبَادَتِ. There'll be challenges, but be constant in your ibadati, in your worship. هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيًّا. Do you know of anyone similar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Here we have concluded four rukus. The Surah to Maryam consists of two rukus. In the last 10 minutes, we will now focus simply on the translation, because there are many themes. But the last two rukus focus in the belief in Allah and belief in the Akhirah. وَيَقُولُ الْإِنسَانُ وَإِذَا مَا مِتُّ لَسَوْفَ أُخْرَجُ حَيًّا أَوَلَا يَذْكُرُ الْإِنسَانُ أَنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ قَبَلُ وَلَمْ يَكُ شَيْئًا فَوَرَبِّكَ لَنَحْشُرَنَّهُمْ وَالشَّيَاطِينَ ثُمَّ لَنُحْضِرَنَّهُمْ حَوْلَ جَهَنَّمَ جِثِيًّا ثُمَّ لَنَنْزِعَنَّ مِنْ كُلِّ شِيعَةٍ أَيُّهُمْ أشد على الرحمن عتيا ثم لنحن أعلم بالذين هم أولى بها صليا. These verses are so powerful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains the person who denies ba'ath ba'd al-maut, resurrection. And Allah says, وَيَقُولُ الْإِنسَانُ, and the human says, the disbeliever says, أَيْذَا مِتُّ, when I die, لَسَوْفَ أُخْرَجُ حَيَّا, will I be brought into existence, hayya, living? And they mocked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When a person is lowered in the grave, he turns into ashes, he turns into bones, he has no reality. How can a person be resurrected alive? Allah says, awala yadhkuru al-insan, does the human not recall, anna khalaqnahu, we created him, min qablu, before, walam yaku shay'a, and he was not even in existence. Who gave you existence? So how is it difficult upon Allah to give you yunshi'un nash'at al-akhirah, another existence, another creation? فَوَرَبِّكْ, Allah takes an oath, aapke rab ki qasam, لَنَحْشُرَنَّهُمْ نَشَّيَاطِينَ, we shall gather them and the devils, ثُمَّ لَنُحْضِرَنَّهُمْ, we shall hum unko hazir karenge, that we shall present them, حَوْلَ جَهَنَّمْ, around the Jahannam. Is this what you rejected? Is this what you denied? Jithiyah, they'll be crying, they'll be weeping, they will be in ultimate humiliation. Jithiyah, they will be on their knees. They'll be crying and weeping. Allow us to return, but there will be no return. Then Allah says, just as Jannah has ranks, the more closer to Allah you are, the more righteous actions, we will be in a greater level of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us Jannatul Firdaus. May Allah give us the highest level of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to accompany He Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Jannah has ranks. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, as for A'la, the highest rank, Jahannam also has ranks. Allah says, ثُمَّ لَنَنْزِعَنَّ مِنْ كُلِّ شِيعَةٍ, then we shall drag from every Shia. Shia is a group. From every group. أَيُّهُمْ أَشَدُّ عَلَى الرَّحْمَانِ عِتِيَّةٍ, the ones who are the worst against Ar-Rahman in their rebellion, and they will be punished double. Allah says, لَنَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِالَّذِينَ هُمْ أَوْلَى بِيَسْلِيَا, we know of those who are the worthy of being burnt in Jahannam. And they will burn in Jahannam. There will be an accountability. Either adopt the ways of the prophets and be entered into Jannah, or adopt the ways of those who oppose. Either adopt the ways of Ibrahim alayhi salam, who migrated from his land. You may fear his persecution. You may need to leave your homes and travel to Habasha. Be from those prophets who migrated. Do not be of those people who were the cause of the prophets moving away from their homeland. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن مِّنكُم إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَّقْضِيًّا ثُمَّ نُنَجِّي الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَنَذَرُ الظَّالِمِينَ فِيهَا جِثِيًّا. There is none from amongst the human, but they will pass over Jahannam. So every person will have to pass over Jahannam on the day of judgment. كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَّقْضِيًّا, this is a decree which will be accomplished. So everyone will have to pass over Jahannam. What does this mean? As we know, the disbelievers will enter into Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guaranteed the believers Jannah, either in the first instance or ultimately. But Allah says, وَإِن مِّنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا, each person has to pass Jahannam. The first explanation is that everyone will pass Jahannam, but Allah will allow the Jahannam to be called for the believers. Just as Ibrahim alayhi salam was thrown in the fire, but Allah commanded, kuni barda, become cold, and he was safe. So the believers will enter into Jahannam and then enter into Jannah, but they will not be harmed by Jahannam at all. Whilst the same fire for the disbelievers will be burning. The second explanation is that they will be able to cross over safely over the pul sirat, the bridge, and enter into Jannah. There will be those who will be, according to the actions, be able to pass over and cross the sirat, the bridge, and enter into Jannah. There will be those who will be touched by the hooks of Jahannam, and they will fall off the sirat and the bridge, and will fall directly into Jahannam. May Allah protect us. Allah says, ثُمَّ نُنَجِّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا. We shall protect and save الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا, the righteous people. Why is taqwa? The ulama says, الْخَوْفُ مِنَ الْجَلِيلِ, خَوْفُ and fear of the Jaleel, Almighty Allah. الْعَمَلُ بِالْتَنْزِيلِ, practicing upon Tanzeel, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-kana'atu bil-kaleel, to suffice on the little that we have. And al-isti'adadu liyawmi al-raheel, and to create an isti'adad, an ability to be able to be reckoned on the day of judgment, and to pass and go and enter into Jannah. There are some verses, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when our verses are read, the alladhina kafaru, the disbelievers say to the believers, ayyul fariqayni khayrun maqama wa ahsanu nadiya. This is important. Sometimes we may see the disbelievers, Allah's given them homes, Allah's given them luxurious lives, Allah allows them to go on holidays, they ride beautiful cars, they have beautiful professions, they have beautiful families, as we assume. And the people of Makkah, they had their homes, they had their luxury, they had their pursuits. Whilst these poor Muslims were driven away from their homes, they had no money, they had no professions, they were mocked, they were ridiculed. And they said, Ayyul Fariqain, look at the believers, they have nothing. Look at the disbelievers, they can live their lives. They can eat as they wish, they can drink, they can fulfill their desires as they wish. So they mocked them. Khayrun maqama wa ahsanu nadiya. Tell us, who is the best in home and who is in the best of gatherings? Look at our gatherings, celebrations, rejoice, party, fun, enjoyment. Whilst look at the life of a Muslim, so depressing. Allah responds later. And He said, have you not seen many generations that we've destroyed? They were in better form of wealth and belongings and in appearance than you were. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الضَّلَالَةِ فَلْيَمْدُدْ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنُ مَدَّا حَتَّى إِذَا رَوْا مَا يُعَدُونَ إِمَّا الْعَذَابَ وَإِمَّا السَّاعَةِ. Say, one who is in dalala, gumrahi, in astray, فَلْيَمْدُدْ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنُ مَدَّا. Allah will allow him. Allah will allow him. Allah usko deal dete, Allah respites him. Eventually he will see that which he's been promised. Al-adhab wa imma sa'ad, the punishment of Allah. Then he will know, sharrun makana wa da'afu junna, who is in the worst of places, who is in the worst of parting and a company. In this world, they may have all the luxuries, they may have the riches, but this world never matters. What mattered is always in the hereafter. وَيَزِيدُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْ هُدَىٰ, and Allah increases in guidance those who yearn to Him. Cry unto Allah and Allah will increase you. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ خَيْرٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ مَرَدًّا. Allah says, the material world and the luxury, it'll come and go, come and go. But what will benefit you in the hereafter? What will be the best in returns? As businessman, he spends money, he takes a loss because he knows it's an investment. So the investment is in baqiyatu salihat, everlasting virtuous actions. Your salah, your dhikr, these will remain. Ad-dunya mazra'atul akhirah, the dunya is a plantation of the hereafter. Sow the seeds, it will reap benefits and fruits in the hereafter. Then in the last 1.5 sides, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to a particular account. There was a man, there was a disbeliever known as Al-As bin Wa'il. He had many people working for him. From amongst them was Khabbab bin Arat radiallahu anhu. Khabbab bin Arat radiallahu anhu was a goldsmith. And he was owed wages. So Khabbab bin Arat asked for his wages. As bin Wail knew that Khabbab bin Arat radiallahu anhu had become a Muslim. He said to him, I will not give you your wages until you refute, you deny, you renounce the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Khabbab bin Arat said, how can I do this? I left all the luxuries, all the comfort for my belief in the Prophet. I will not deny my Prophet until you die and you are resurrected. Now he mocked and ridiculed. As bin Wail say, will I die and be resurrected? huh, you will die and you will be resurrected. So Aas bin Wail said, fine. If I'll die and be resurrected, I have all the children, I have all the wealth, then the wages I owe you, come to me in the hereafter. I will also have the same wealth and the same provisions. I will give to you from that account. And he ridiculed him, mocked him, and turned away. If I have in this world, I will have in the next also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ بِآيَاتِنَا وَقَالَ لَأُوتَيَنَّ مَالًا وَوَلَدًا أَطَّلَعَ الْغَيْبَ أَمِ اتَّخَذَ عِندَ الرَّحْمَنِ عَهْدًا كَلَّا سَنَكْتُبُ مَا يَقُولُ وَنَمُدُّ لَهُ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ مَجًّا وَنَرِثُهُ مَا يَقُولُ وَيَأْتِينَا فَرْدًا. Have you seen the one, Aas bin Wail, الَّذِي كَفَرْ, جِسْنِ كُفَرْ كَيَا, who disbelieved the آيَاتِنَا in our verses. And he said, لَأُوتَيَنَّ مَالًا وَوَلَدًا, I will be given mal, wealth, and وَوَلَدًا, and progeny. Allah says, أَطَّلَعَ الْغَيْبِ, has he been made aware of the unseen? Does he know something that others don't know? That certainly he will have this? Does he know that he is going to enter into Jannah? Does he know he has been given the certificate of pass? أَمِتَّخَذَ عِنْدَ الرَّحْمَانِ عَدَى, or does he have a contact? Does he have a promise with Allah? كَلَّا, never. كَلَّا سَنَكْتُبُ مَا يَكُلْ, everything that the person says we are writing and recording. وَنَمُدُّ لَهُ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ مَدَّى, we shall increasing him in عَذَاب. وَنَرِثُهُ مَا يَكُلْ, is he proud of his wealth? Is he proud of his home? Is he proud of his business? If he is proud of his investment? جَاءَتْ سَكَرَةُ الْمَوْتِ, the death and the mort will strike and nothing belongs to him anymore. وَنَرِثُهُ مَا يَقُولُ, we shall inherit everything that belongs to him and everything he says. وَيَأْتِينَا فَرْدًا, and when he comes to us, he will come farda. Farda means individually. وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً لِيَكُونُوا لَهُمْ عِزَّا كَلَّا سَيَكْفُرُونَ بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ وَيَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ ضِدًّا. Do they ascribe partners to Allah? Why to give them honor and dignity? Do not compromise with your faith so that you have honor at workplace, at home, in culture, on the streets, in order to have a name, to have honor and izzah. Do not compromise with your faith. Why? This same wealth, this same fame, this same partners to Allah, سَيَكْفُرُونَ بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ, will deny being partners to Allah and will be your opponents on the Day of Judgment. And the last page, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا الشَّيَاطِينَ عَلْ الْكَافِرِينَ تَأُزُّهُمْ أَزَّا. We have allowed the shayateen to be dominant over them. What does shayateen do? He pushes them in evil. Pushes them in evil. Inclines them towards evil until they create their own plot of Jahannam. فَلَا تَعْجَلْ عَلَيْهِمْ, don't hasten. The Muslims were suffering. If we're on the truth, a lot of youngsters ask, if we're on the truth, why does Allah not assist us? Why does Allah still provide for the disbelievers? Allah already responded. Allah is providing the disbelievers to give them respite and allow them time. But فَلَا تَعْجَلْ عَلَيْهِمْ, no, don't be hasty. Don't be quick. إِنَّمَا نَعُدُّ لَهُمْ عَدَّا, we are counting the number of days. Beautifully a poet says, حَيَاتُكَ أَنْفَاسٌ تُعَدُّ فَكُلَّمَا, حَيَاتُكَ أَنْفَاسٌ تُعَدُّ فَكُلَّمَا, مَضَى نَفْسٌ مِنْكَ إِنْ تَقَصْتَ بِهِ جُزْءًا, يُمِيتُكَ مَا يُحْيِيكَ فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ وَيَحْدُوكَ حَادٍ مَا يُرِيدُ بِهِ هُزْءًا. Your life are few breaths. Your life is few breaths. فَكُلَّمَا مَضَى نَفْسٌ مِنْكَ, each time you take a breath, you are losing a part of you. So Allah has allowed a number of breaths for each person. Imagine this. And each time you are breathing, you are drawing more closer to your death. يُمِيتُكَ مَا يُحْيِيكَ, the breath which allows you to live, is in fact drawing you closer to your death. Each night, each morning, you are taking a step closer to your death. إِنَّمَا نَعُدُّ لَهُمْ عَدَّا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, These verses are so powerful. يَوْمَ نَحْشُرُ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِلَى الرَّحْمَنِ وَفْدًا وَنَسُوقُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدًا لَا يَمْلِكُونَ الشَّفَاعَةَ إِلَّا مَنِ اتَّخَذَ عِنْدَ الرَّحْمَنِ عَهْدًا. The day of judgment. So belief in Allah, belief in the prophets, belief in resurrection, the last day. The day when we shall gather the muttaqeen, taqwa wale, the God-fearing people, to Rahman, wafda, in groups as guests. We will be the guests. Who will be the host? Ar-Rahman, Allah. Nuzulam min ghafoorir raheem. Imagine that. Allah will be our host. We will be the guests. Allah will provide. Allah says, wafda, you will be my guests. You will be my guests. Why? You fasted away from these things in the dunya. And your iftari will be on my dastarkhan. But وَنَسُوكُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدَىٰ. If you are a mujrim, criminal, if you followed your desires, if you did not understand my words, if you did not fulfill the commandments of mine, we will nasuk, we will drag you إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدَىٰ, to Jahannam wirda. Wirda means thirsty. They will be on their knees. They will be thirsty, but their thirst will not be quenched. And there will be no one's intercession that will be accepted from them, but for whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discusses, قَالُ اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا لَكَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْنْ إِدَّا. Do they say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a child? تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْ وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضِ وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدَّا. أَنْدَعَوْ لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدًا. How can they ascribe partners to Allah? It's soon, it's almost that the skies will torn and will split open. وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضِ. And the earth will split asunder. وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدَّا. And the mountains will fall into ruin. How can they ascribe partners to Allah? How can they say Allah has a child? Allah has no child. Allah has no wife. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. Allahu الصَّمَدْ. لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. Allah has no children. He has no parents. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَوْ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. He has no partner to him. Firstly, this is our belief. Secondly, it is important we believe in one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, we live our lives in a way which shows that there is only one Allah. Do not run and chase the dunya, the makhluk. Otherwise, this person is ascribing these their power to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Turn to Allah. وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلرَّحْمَانِ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا. It is not appropriate for Ar-Rahman to have a child. إِن كُلُّ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِ الرَّحْمَانِ عَبْدًا. How powerful is this? Allah says, إِن كُلُّ. Everything in the skies, on the earth, آتِ الرَّحْمَانِ. آئِي رَحْمَانِ كَيْ پَاس. Will come to Rahman. أَبَدًا. As a humble servant, you like it or not, you're a believer or not, you enjoyed your life or not, you brought faith or not, you will come to Rahman Abda. Either you will come as his guest or you'll be dragged thirsty and thrown in Jahannam. لَكَدْ أَحْصَاهُمْ وَعَدَّمْ Abda. We know them well. We are counting their numbers. We are counting their breaths. كُلُّهُمْ. All of them. آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدَى. Will come to Allah Farda alone. And in the last verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدَّا. Verily those who bring faith and do righteous actions, Allah will instill for them love in the hearts of people. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a person, then he calls Jibreel and he says that Allah loves Fulah, so and so person, love him. When Jibreel loves him, he makes a pukar and an announcement in the heavens that Allah loves so and so, you angels also love him so and so. So much so, ثُمَّ يُوضَعُ لَهُ الْقُبُولُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Then Allah instills acceptance for this person in the hearts of people, so people love them. This is qubuliyya. This is acceptance directly from Allah, that it's a sign from Allah that Allah loves this person. But when a person sins, Allah dislikes, Jibreel dislikes, also the people in the heavens, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ridicules this person. Lastly, Allah says, فَإِنَّمَا يَسَّرْنَاهُ بِلِسَانِكَ لِتُبَشِّرَ بِهِ الْمُتَّقِينَ وَتُنذِرَ بِهِ قَوْمًا لُدَّا. O Prophet, we made the Qur'an, يَسَّرْنَاهُ, asan, easy, بِلِسَانِكَ, upon your tongue. Qur'an, which is in Arabic, he was ummi, لِتُبَشِّرَ بِهِ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Why it is the purpose of the Quran to give glad tidings to the muttaqeen, the righteous people, وَتُنْذِرَ بِهِ قَوْمًا لُدَّا, and to warn the quarrelsome people. Allah says, وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبَلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنِ. How many a generation before them we destroyed? They were arrogant. أَثَاثَ وَرِئَا. They had beautiful homes. They caved their homes in mountains. They were strong. They were courageous. But هَلْ تُحِسُّ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ. Do you see any of them? Do you find any of them anymore? إِنْ فَتَسْمَعُ لَهُمْ رِكْزَا. Do you even hear a whisper from them? Their wealth, their progeny, their offspring was not able to save them. What makes you think will protect you? If anything that will protect you is baqiyatu salihat, the righteous actions. So this was the last verse of Surah Maryam. So as a summary, the first ruku, it discussed the birth of Yahya alayhi salam. Zakaria alayhi salam was almost 120 years old. His wife has been said to be around 98. The impossible becomes possible. Why nida'an khafiya? That cry in the deafness of the night to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second ruku focus on the birth and the teachings of Isa alayhi salam. The third and the fourth ruku was the virtues and the merits of the anbiya, that Musa alayhi salam was given the aid, his brother, he was the kalimullah. Ibrahim alayhi salam stayed steadfast. Ismail alayhi salam was sadiq al-wa'd, he was truthful in his speech and he forbid evil and he spoke of good. Idris alayhi salam was raised in the heavens. Isa alayhi salam was raised in the heavens. If these prophets came before, likewise Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a prophet also, so follow him. The fifth ruku spoke about the life after death, that belief in the akhirah, you will be resurrected, there will be reckoning, the believers will enter into Jahannam, whilst the disbelievers will be driven and dragged into Jahannam, wirda, as they will be thirsty. And lastly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is free from any children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is free from being ascribed with any partners. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability, firstly, yatlu alayhim ayati, recite the verses of the Quran, wa yuzakihim, and then to purify our souls with the love of ghayr, other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yuzakihim, to purify our souls with the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yu'allimuhum al-kitab, to learn the book of Allah and then to preach it and teach it to others. Wal hikmah, and the ways of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our sitting. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our understanding and listening to the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and make this verse and of Surah to Maryam, and make this means as being closer to Allah and Allah's word. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد ربنا هب لنا من وذرياتنا قرة عين وجعلنا للمتقين اماما رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا ربنا اغفر لنا ولاخواننا الذين سبقونا بالايمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين امنوا ربنا انك رؤوف رحيم ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين